Back to Gran Turismo campaign mode, professional league, premium sport launch. A few more races left, three to be exact. Monza's next, a temple of speed. We need really, really fast car for that one. I used those four so far. I don't want to reuse the cars, so let's see what others cars are available for us. They have to be really fast for that racetrack, I guess. Maybe tuned Corvette, that should do. I don't know how fast is that Amuse S2000 GT1. I like to believe it's quite fast. It's light and has a lot of horsepower. But it's not Corvette, is it? Let's go with the Corvette. We may need to tune it up at least to 600 from 500 group. Just three tunes per power and weight. Okay, let's start with adding some more weight power. It can go up to 700. Let's keep it at 600. Let's reduce the traction control to zero and give it some racing tires. I'll go with soft. I go with soft just because it's underpowered in comparison to their cars. So some more grip to catch them up at turns. So I think Corvette, do we have manual? We do. I think Corvette is modern enough to have puddles, but we'll see in a moment. Yeah, I can pick their puddles there. They're not, I don't know. Let's adjust the cockpit view. Puddles in the car or not. Actually, no, there are no puddles. So he takes the hand out of the wheel to change the gear. Let's stop. What the hell is going on? Oh, come on, I can't check it. I'm sure I can check it. It doesn't really show, actually. Try to change the gear. Okay, so it looks like it's a normal traditional 8 shifter. And if this is the true, then I'm really surprised. But let's do it proper way. If it's a 8 shifter, it's 8 shifter. And a clutch. Huge surprise. This seems to be a good brakes, though. Really good brakes. Thank you. braking too early in this car. Citizen Jaguar versus American V8. No chance whatsoever. Try something now. I wanted to make sure that clutch works properly, so I tried to upshift all clutch, and as I found out, it works properly. That was pretty cool. I guess I won't have any chance with that Fernando on straight. Yeah, that's what I thought. That was Bugatti Veyron. Was. Past tense. Not sure if I'll be able to keep him behind me on the long straight. It's already catching up. I manage, and I don't think I have to worry about him anymore. It's already almost 4 seconds advantage, and I will get a bit more on another corner. Clutch check didn't work. Stop that car in time for that chicane. That was a stupid mistake. Shifted instead of upshifting to 5, I pretty much downshifted to 3, but realized my mistake fast enough to change that and fix it. Looks like my leg is too quick for my hand. Releasing the clutch before the gear is in. Final lap. 10 out of 10. That's a back marker, so we should be seeing a blue flag already. He almost pushed me over the truck there. And it's both clean race bonus plus car handicap. Nice bonus overall. Good experience points. That's all towards this level 50. And a fastest lap, which is a big surprise with AI. Two more trucks. Next one is Fuji. I'll be right back to try that one. So, back to the Gran Turismo campaign mode, Premium Sports Launch Race 6 Fuji Speedway. Japanese truck requires Japanese car. I think it's fitting, right? So, what Japanese cars, powerful Japanese cars, do I have? I should have, for example, that Muse. Or the Lexus. Not sure which one would be better to pick, Lexus or Muse. I'll go with this one. I've never driven this one. Again, no idea if that car has manual, sequential. It hasn't locked here. It needs to lock so I can actually. There we go, now it locked. So not sure if it has manual gearbox or whatever there is, so we'll have to have a look. First of all, disable traction control, install racing mediums. The soft proved to be too good for AI. I was maybe gonna go with hard. Here we go, racing hard. That car is N60 and I want to keep it N60. But it's possible I can keep it N60 with a bit more power. I don't need it to be lighter, it's quite light already. Oh, so I can only reduce it, I cannot increase it. So it's maximum. Great, that was a waste of... Watch, I've got abundance of... So that's the maximum can go with it. Can I actually reduce the weight of that car? Can, but I don't want to. Let's keep it 100-100. Racing hard, traction control off. Now that's quite an old car, so I'm assuming it's 8-shifter. We'll find out soon enough. Starting the race. Yeah, so I can see that it's already 5th gear. 6th gear. And yeah, I can see the driver takes the hands off the wheel to change the gear, so it has to be 8-shifter. Oh, that's 7th gear, great. Okay, I was braking too early. That car has quite got good brakes. Thanks for hitting me. Whoa. I would prefer not to have to use the 7th gear. What a beast. The main reason for that is that to put the 7th gear I need to actually press the shifter down, like with the reverse. Not 5th, 3rd. A small mischief there. Oh, this is... okay. I thought this is the full version, this is the short version. Without a chicane. Overpowered. I need to adjust the view. Cockpit view. First of all, I want to edit as back as possible and then one lower. And now that bloody 7th gear, it's not the best way to put it in, but actually that's the only way, so I have to press it and put 7, which is a slower way. And now that car has a good brake, so I'll try to brake later. I wasn't best braking, I need to get used to it. The really, really small beast that S2000. I think the 3rd gear may be a better option there. Quite short as well. I could have changed them, made them a bit longer just to use the 6 gears instead of 7. Seven gear is a beast. Was close. Thank you. Okay, I'm going to do two things. First of all, I don't like those gears. Putting 7 gear on the 8 shifter is very difficult because I need to press it down and it goes where normally 5 would be. So, what I want to do is go to the gearbox. Where's the bloody gearbox? Transmission. Yeah, it is manual. That will be sequential. Okay, that'll be better. So, yeah, I'm happy with the sequential. I need to switch it to sequential. There we go. That's sequential now. Also so much easier with sequential without having to use the clutch. That car has some crazy acceleration. It's so light, just 1100 kilograms. $1 million car versus whatever the Lamuse cost, definitely not even close to that. they wanted to avoid that guy. Ferrari was going sideways though, like crazy. Wow, he's fast, it's catching up like crazy as well. Still breaking a bit too late. I should have taken sports tire, that car on racing tires, even though they're hard, so fast. Thank you. What happened here? Laps to go. Thank you. What a stupid mistake. There will be a real life race, that will be the end of it. Final lap. Just enough to put that 7 gear on. Yeah, unfortunately I lost my clean race bonus. Two big mistakes. And it's all lost. Okay, so what do we have? We've got one more race, a final one. That's another truck I don't know because it's a fantasy truck. Just 5 laps, so I'm assuming it's really long. Okay, really long truck. I need a car which I haven't been using. That would be cool. Or maybe Mustang. Go with Mustang. That one. Nice color. So that Mustang is a GT3 road car, I think. The Corvette GT3 had a manual 8-shifter. Not sure what to expect from this one. So first of all, let's do some tuning there. I want it a bit lighter. No, let's buy some upgrades first. Here we go. Now I want it lighter. And then buy some here and give it some more power, so it's an N600 car, just N600. So what's the higher bracket for N600? So the higher bracket is 639, and lower bracket is 543. It's almost 100 horsepower difference. So let's agree to disagree and put it at just below 600. Okay, not sports, racing mediums for that car. It's mid 600 brake balance. It's a race car in a road version, so zero. And this is fully customizable mechanical LSD. I know, I want the gearbox. That's sequential transmission. Okay, but we could go manual. Sequential. Obviously, sequential is much easier to drive. A manual gives me a bit more fun. Let's go with the manual. Yeah, okay, it's going to be hard because I don't know the racetrack, so. Wait, I need to switch it to manual. Here we go. That should be manual now. Does it work? I don't know. We'll find out in a moment. Fifth gear, I think it works. Gear. And I have no idea what I'm driving. won't crash into anyone. That car sounds amazing. So I'm negotiating these corners and I'm hoping they're not... They're not too strong and I'm not driving too fast. Does it really have 7th gear? No, it doesn't. It's 6th gear. It's a 6th gear manual transmission. And it's too short. Why is he braking? Okay, that's why he's braking. It's so hard to drive if one doesn't know the racetrack. As long as I have someone in front of me, I can tell more or less how the truck goes. But as soon as I'm going to be first, it's going to be a nightmare. I have no idea how... how fast I should be going in these corners. Kamikaze in that Dodge Viper. So this is 6th gear, I don't have a 7th one, and it's a problem, like, should I be braking already? The second one, I think. That seems like a full throttle one, and it is. So that was the first lap out of 5, okay, they're quite long, what's the time? 4 minutes, bloody hell, that's really long. Okay, I was lucky here. So I should have been on the second gear in that corner. I think this is the long straight where the 6th gear is not enough. There we go. And I don't have a 7th one. Okay, they're braking, so I should be braking as well, I guess. They are definitely have a better brakes than they do. Bloody hell, okay. I saved that one. That was a blind corner, completely hidden. So I remember that that was a left-hander. It was a very long corner, okay. And it was a very narrow one. Almost a hairpin. Bugatti or not, I don't care, it's behind me. Okay, so the McLaren was first one, and I think he will actually get me on that straight. He's already catching up. That's the maximum I can go. Close one, red barrier. Thank you. Okay, I was trying to save that car from going out the track. I think I'm still driving within my clean race bonus and I want to keep it. But it's really hard if one doesn't know the track. And this is just the fourth lap and I don't remember all the corners still. For that type of driving. Final lap. That's a good one actually. Faster at corner. At least I can have some coffee now. Mistake, I've shifted to 5th rather than the 3rd one, but quickly corrected that mistake. And we're all good. I messed up everything and the last... That's the thing, I thought it's a different corner. That goes my clean race bonus. What a shame, but it is what it is. And it's over. That was the last race from the Premium Sports Lounge. Race 7, I believe it was. A lot of fun. Yeah, at least I got a car handicap bonus, but... No. Could have been much better. Especially I need every experience point to get level 50 trophy. Good, I think that's enough for today. That was my second session and they both were more than an hour. And I'm done with that. The tier, I don't remember if I finished the midship. Yeah, I did. Midship challenge. So the next one will be La Festa Cavallino. And some good Ferraris. I don't have such a huge choice. I got 1, 2, 3. But I don't think I want to use the GT3. Because there won't be any racing cars there, I guess. There will be just the sports car. Let's just see here. No GT3. Sure is available, but main rivals are not using it. So, in preparation for this one, let's go shopping. I don't have much credits because I spent 20 million for a Ford. But I should be able to buy something with that million credits. Italy, Ferrari. Showroom. Yeah, I've got this one. I don't have Italia. Okay. This one, this one, this one. If I could get La Ferrari, how much this? 1.6, 185. Bloody head expense. Get Italia. But I also could go racing, earn some more credits, then go shopping. I really want this one, this one. Don't care that much about LaFerrari. Okay, that will be for tomorrow. And for today, it's over. Thank you all for watching. Have a good evening. And I see you next time.